For the past 16 years, classes from schools around Southwest Washington have packed into buses and headed to rivers, streams, and lakes throughout the Chehalis Basin watershed.
We've had a lot of rain lately, haven't we?
Well, what do you call it when your dirt falls off?
Erosion?
They're involved in a science education program that teaches them about one of the most important environmental factors of the 21st century, the cleanliness and health of our water. And this isn't just a field trip, it's field research. Twice throughout the year, the classes of 4th through 8th graders return to the same location to test the quality of the water. The program is called the Chehalis Basin Education Consortium.
Content with the peroxide.
Oh no, we have to add 8 drops of sulfuric acid.
Oh, 8 drops of sulfuric acid.
Right here. Alright, ready? Can you see it?
Is it going to explode?
No, honey. I wouldn't have you do anything that was exploding.
That would be
good.
Kind
Stop.
Of fun. Okay. 5, 6. Come on. 6.
One more. Okay. Now, what does it say to do, Katie Jo?
Windows match the best match
4.0
between 2 color segments.
4.5.
Right. Yep. So now this time, Drake, you're going to go really, really slow and listen for Casey to say stop.
The program wraps up each year in the spring, as the classes meet up for the Chehalis Basin Student Congress. This year, about 250 students came together at Centralia Community College for the Congress. They discussed their findings, and together they brainstormed solutions to the problems affecting Washington's waters.
What just happened with this cloud coming in front of the sun?
Shade.
Shade, right. I just felt it getting noticeably cooler in here, right, when that's up.
I'm going to. And do you have an idea? You guys all have stickers. Just go for it.
Scientists, business people, and other volunteers also attended the event to teach the kids about a broad range of topics that impact our land, air, water, and wildlife.
Fish that we raise and grow and then let into our rivers when they're adults. So they're different from wild fish. They have different genes. So this
all is energy. Into making those two organs.
Which one's
blackberry?
This one? They put carbon dioxide bubbles into it, and it's the carbon dioxide bubbles in your soft drinks that make them more acidic. Okay?
Mussels, and there's sand dollars, and there's barnacles, and there's different types of shellfish. There's even some slipper limpets, and I think I have a calcareous tube worm in here.
You can leave it in there.
So what are you noticing with the vinegar, you guys?
It's bubbling.
It's bubbling. What do you think those bubbles are? Do you remember when we, up in the play, when we blew the bubbles? What is that gas?
It's
carbon dioxide bubbles.
Water is gold. In our world, it is our lifeblood. We need it for everything. And keeping it clean, cold, and readily available is going to be key to a legacy that I want to pass on to my kids and my grandkids.
I think this is where you start. You know, you start by loving a place and by getting to know your watersheds and by appreciating what they have to offer, and hopefully that's enough to make you want to protect them into the future.
And we get out of the classroom and we get to go see and do something that doesn't happen every day, and that's what kids remember, and that's what makes school fun. It makes them more global and a better understanding of where they live.